woman is here.
Okay, your mouth. I'm gonna show you women.
All you do is run your mouth.
If you all day,
do is run your mouth.
This is him.
That's
all day,
you.
Every day.
You
day
right.
Did you actually sleep with Naya?
No, I didn't, but if I wanted to, I could have.
What's the matter with your leg?
I'm just ready.
Then, did you tell your ex that you're currently in a relationship?
You still love this guy, or
I'm
gonna meet somebody else.
Both of you guys.
Is this a picture of your ex?
Mm-hmm.
So when was the last time you saw him?
Oh, wow.
Come on out! Plus, you, like Aisha, dabbled in illegal plastic surgery, right?
I lost both of my feet, both of my hands, and my butt cheeks.
I remember this so well.
What happened after the show?
That's right now. What do you get when you mix latex, your lover, and a blood relative? Pure drama. That's exactly what's happening with my next guest, who says he's been devastated by his cousin's actions after a shocking discovery. He's here today in search of one thing, the truth. So please welcome Darius to the show. Darius.
Yeah.
Looking as lovely as ever.
Yes, delicious.
So, what discovery did you make this week?
Nayet is sleeping with my man. Period. That's my cousin. Like, why would you do that?
So your cousin, Nayet,
yes,
is sleeping with your man.
Yeah.
How do you know that?
I went to the supermarket to go buy some food for us to cook dinner. I was trying to be nice. So we see, we trying to be nice. It happens to you, we trying to be nice.
Right. Right. Now, so you came home.
I came home. I comes back upstairs. He has a towel on. She's sitting on the couch with her robe on like this. And I see a condom sitting on the floor.
So she's wearing a bathrobe?
A bathrobe. A big fat lady bathrobe, yes.
And he's wearing a towel?
And a towel.
And is your boyfriend bisexual?
Yeah.
His name's Brandon, right?
Yeah, Brandon the boo-boo fool.
So did you confront him right then and there when you came back?
Yes, I did. I went right off.
And?
And then that's when he was acting stupid. So I said, I don't know what you're talking about.
So what did you do when he said, I don't know what you're talking about?
I went crazy. I started throwing everything all over the house. I started knocked all her stuff off her dresser and everything. Because I'm crazy. And I would show them crazy.
So why do you think your cousin, right? Why do you think your cousin would do something this scandalous to you?
Because she's spiteful and evil sometimes. Like, I don't understand what the problem is. I never done nothing wrong to this girl. Like, she done been through my phone, trying to go through my text messages, trying to find out all my personal stuff, all my business and stuff like that. Like, why would you? I don't do that to you.
So you think she's what?
I don't know. I think she's jealous of me, period, y'all. Yeah. Yeah. I think she's jealous of me. Because I look good.
She wants to be me.
I look good. Okay? And I think she's just jealous of me, period.
Do you regret living with her?
We have fun times, you know, but then it's just like the spiteful little thing that she does. So, like, that's my opera on the show today. Like, what's the issue?
I think it's time to meet this young lady. Nayet, come on out.
Jealous of you? Me jealous of you?
You're very jealous
of me. This is like something that makes me jealous of this.
You're jealous. You're jealous.
How you doing?
You're very jealous.
The real woman is here.
Okay, you're mad. I can show you woman, honey. You want to see woman, honey? Because I can show you woman. Come on, take that. Come on, my aunt, take that. I can show you woman, honey. Fix that body. Make her look cute.
Yeah, it looks good.
Yes.
A hot DMS.
A hot hater.
Wow.
You should have put some lotion on.
My lotion on? I know you're not talking about that cellulite on your leg.
You should have put some lotion on.
You're mad because I have good legs. That's why you're another hater. Because I have Tina legs.
Who's Tina?
Tina Turner.
Tina Turner.
That's who he thinks he is. That's what you call delusional.
So I have to ask this question straight up, Nayette.
You kind of yes.
Did you sleep with his man?
No, I did not. He's insecure. He's very delusional. He puts stuff together in his head. So because I look better than him, as you can see.
Girl, that's what you do.
He automatically assumes that somebody sleeps with him.
But he came back from the store. He found you in a bathing robe, right?
Yes, but that's my house. So okay. I feel like I can be around my house. You guys came to me with nowhere to go.
She got tight now.
And I let you come and whatever. I honestly feel like he planted the condom.
So is it true that Nayette spreads rumors about you?
Oh, the damn
what
time.
What type of rumors are those?
Oh, he don't clean up the house. He's dirty.
No, you are.
He don't pay my. He don't pay his rent. I have never been dirty. I know you're not saying. You neat nasty. She's
usually dirty.
You
trying
to make everybody clean up.
No.
And then you do the same exact stuff everybody else do. Sit down. Sit down.
Let me tell you. Let me tell you what he does. First of all, I don't like nobody eating in my living room. First of all, you don't pay rent. You haven't paid for my furniture.
Lies.
You don't do anything in that house.
Lies.
I pay for it when
lies you tell.
Okay. anyway.
Okay, you fake J-Lo.
Why is she a fake J-Lo?
Look at her body. She look terrible. She's a fake J-Lo. She's squishy. This is what she likes to do.
With damn Mother Hills.
So where did this condom come from?
Cheese.
Okay.
Darius, what we call Cheese.
Okay.
He came in my room, and he brought a condom in there yelling or whatever. Mind you, it was only me and Brandon here all day. Brandon is what he is. I have a baby father, my kid's father and two kids. I don't know what possessed him to think that I would actually go out and sleep with somebody who is him.
Okay.
You get my point. And he came in here, whatever, and he was like, oh, mind you, every day, though, he starts little arguments. Like, if me and Brandon in the kitchen cooking this, like, which I just was on the counter, and like, what? Like, he's very jealous and insecure.
Has Brandon ever hit on you?
No. Brandon never tried
Why
nothing
would I
with
be jealous
me.
Of you?
So, he started knocking off my TV. He knocked off, like, my picture frames that I have with my kids on my dresser. He knocked all of those down.
I sure enough did.
Yeah, because he wants to be me, though.
Did.
That's what nobody doesn't understand. He wants to be a woman. And he doesn't understand
that
never happened.
But she put up my Beyonce and Whitney posters. So that's what she get.
You're not Beyonce or Whitney. You need to get that through your head.
Goodness,
you're overweight.
Girl.
Let's get
all
on the real
right.
issue.
So, all right.
That's your problem.
You really got that overweight? That look good.
You don't. That is.
You don't look good.
No, seriously.
You don't look good.
Because
you have all that makeup on.
Maybe you can get treatment after this show.
I don't need a treatment. My body is good. My body is good, baby.
No.
Look at your body. Look at you. You look ashy.
A big ass mess.
I'm like, I look big and I look very good, though.
You don't.
I'm a BBW.
So I'm going to ask you again. I've already asked you once, but Brandon's never made advances sexually
no,
or any other way.
Brandon don't like women. Brandon likes men.
Brandon's bisexual, right. So I know that he messed around when I get period. I don't care why. We're
do you know he's bisexual?
About the blue.
No, I didn't know he was bisexual.
Girl, you knew that because you done dealt with him. Girl, box.
Really
I'm not.
Has this relationship always been drama-filled?
Always drama. Since we was younger, he's always, like, been a bully.
Oh, you always been
he's
a
always,
hater.
If I dress a certain way, he, like, everybody will tell me I look nice, and he's like, oh, the bitch looks a mess. Like, he's very...
Because you do!
Now, recently...
Do you stretch each other's eyes
out? I don't lie. I tell the truth. She do look a mess. Like, when she look a mess, I'm going to tell the truth. And when she looks nice, I'm going to tell her she look nice. No, don't take it wrong. Don't take it wrong. I don't want her to go outside looking a mess.
So,
people can
Nayette,
call her. I tell her, when she look nice, she look nice.
Darius,
when she look a mess,
Darius,
she look a mess.
Darius, did Nayette tell your family you were gay?
Yeah, she did that.
Yes, I did.
Yeah,
why did you do that?
Because I felt like he was already struggling with it. It was really it was a joke at first, and then
you did it out of spitefulness, like you always want to do.
It was a joke at first, and then it escalated because
That's
once
all.
His father found out, his father's a fireman, so he was like really embarrassed by it.
So you outed him, telling your family that he was gay.
Yes.
And were you ready? Were you ready for that?
I
were you ready, Darius? Were you ready for that? Were you ready?
I wasn't ready for that. I would tell her when I want to tell her. She didn't have to go run her mouth.
Like, but my thing is, if
all you do is run your mouth.
If you all
you
all
do
day,
is run your mouth.
This is him.
That's
all
all
day,
you do.
Every day.
You're damn right. You're damn right.
Supermarket. How the hell you don't think people know you gay?
You're damn right. It's me all damn day. All damn day. All damn 365 damn.
Yeah, and you don't want nobody to know you gay.
I don't give a damn. Good night.
Coming up.
Let me ask you this. Have you slept with anybody else?
Nah. I said we ain't going to talk about when he had your truck.
What happened when he had my truck?
Nothing.
And later, is this a picture of your ex?
That's him.
So when was the last time you saw him?
A while ago.
Come on out.
The break. Love what you're watching from your couch. You want to see us live? Well, if you're in the Los Angeles area and want to be part of my studio audience, go to the robertirvineshow.com now. I want to see you here. Do you think she's jealous of you, right?
She's very jealous of me. She's mad.
Oh my God.
I can dance. I can sing. I am like, all right.
No, please.
Naya, are you jealous
of me? Please don't, please.
Are you jealous of me?
No.
Well, there's another player in the game with drama, Darius's boyfriend. So, well, let's bring him out. Brandon, come on out.
Come on, Brandon.
What's up, Brandon?
Let's go, Brandon.
Hey, man,
how are you?
That's my seat. Sit right there.
Calm your mouth.
That's my seat. Don't put things on your arm.
Watch your hands. A big ass.
Wow. So,
let's go kick your kid.
See?
What's so, Brandon,
you know that? Hey,
you know what?
Kick him off.
Shut up. Let's get through this thing.
Kick him off.
Let's go kick your kid.
So, did you actually sleep with Naya?
No, I didn't, but if I wanted to, I could have.
What does that actually mean?
If I want to, I can have it.
But
it ain't nothing.
Has she ever told you that? Well, how come you're saying
years
that?
Ago? Like we could have played back years ago, before me and him got together.
Okay.
But you
so
know,
where did the condom come from?
I don't know. I think it was planted.
What's the matter with your leg?
Huh?
What's the matter with your leg?
I'm just ready.
I think the condom was planted.
Period.
That's it.
I don't have to plan that.
So there's only three of you in the house, right?
And so I leave.
So I clearly
cleaned up the house before I had left out,
you
and there was a condom on the floor. Yes, I do clean. You don't clean, you neat, nasty heifer.
You never clean the house.
So if you did, Brandon, who planted the condom?
Not yet.
Oh. No, I didn't.
I'm coming out the shower, so you know I don't know what's going on in the living room. Next thing you know, he comes in,
wipe your mouth.
Pursing me out, so this.
Are you bisexual?
Yeah,
I play with. I told you,
ain't no problem.
He's never hit on you. Nia's never hit on you.
Yeah, a couple of times, years back.
I tried to hit on you years ago. But Brandon, when?
Years back.
Because you've been like this your whole life. So when?
Come on now, let's not play like I can't get there.
So you couldn't.
Because
if you could, then you would have gotten.
I could. I got self-control, mama. I got self-control.
Okay, you're going to look. That's
so,
my cousin.
Do you think, Brandon, do you think Darius is...
Your cousin's a big girl. Your cousin's a big girl. She can handle herself.
Calm down.
She can handle herself.
I can't stand that, but that's still my cousin.
You ain't going to do nothing about it.
So, Brandon, do you think
Darius... What do you mean I ain't going to do nothing about it?
You're not doing nothing about it.
What do you mean I'm not going to do nothing about it?
Sit back down.
What do you mean I'm not going to do nothing about it?
Sit back down.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
Because now you
don't step on my toes with no big ass shoes. What do you mean?
Look at your feet, though. I mean, I guess sit your ass down. So,
Brandon, do you think Darius is insecure?
A little bit, yeah.
Insecure of what?
Come on, you almost.
Insecure of what?
You know.
I look good. Okay? My booty is big, okay? I have a nice
shape.
You don't have nothing but stick and bones. You know what?
Bye.
I don't know why
bye.
I was dealing with you at first, but...
Bye.
So why are you, so why are you guys together?
Stick and bones.
Because we had a good connection.
What's a connection?
Like, we had a good connection. Like, we was friends at one point of a time, whatever. And then, then you, like, you know, then the building. Then we got serious.
Toby took it
from Let me ask you a question, Brandon.
Yeah.
You say you didn't sleep with Nia, right?
No, I didn't.
You could have if you wanted to, but you didn't.
Pause.
Right?
I mean, I guess it's
so. Let me ask you this. Have you slept with anybody else?
Boy,
Guess what, Darius? Stay with us. We'll be right back with the results. When we come back.
We ain't gonna do that.
So what you wanna do?
I'm quiet long enough.
Yeah, that's good.
Later, when I saw April and she was the epitome of what you could have become.
I lost both of my feet, both of my hands, and my butt cheeks.
I mean, it hurted me. I mean, because I know it could have been me.
Next, if you're in the Los Angeles area and you want to be part of my studio audience, go to therobertirvineshow.com now and come and join the party. A couple, and I gotta tell you, it just gets funny as we go. We give Brandon a lie detector test to see if he was cheating on Darius.
Well, I have the results here.
Audience, you want to hear the results? Brandon, Darius, stand up and face each other. Nayette, you may want to come over here.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Question one. We asked Brandon, did you have sexual relations with Nayette the day Darius found the condom? Brandon's answer
was no.
Was no. However,
no, I bet you.
The lie detector determined.
I was telling the truth. I bet you. I bet you.
He was telling the truth.
Told you.
Sexual relations. It's not intercourse. We asked Brandon, did you have sexual intercourse with Nayette the day Darius found the condom?
No.
And his answer was no.
Told you. And lie detector test was this? No. Why won't
you? You're so confident about that, right?
Yeah, because I know I did.
Lie detector determined.
I was telling the truth. I bet you.
He was telling the truth.
Do
you have something to say to
Nayette? I'm sorry.
Excuse me after all this, and I'm sorry.
Come on. Oh, give me a hug.
Told you. Didn't I tell you?
He's We're not done yet. We asked question number three. We asked Brandon, have you ever had sexual relations with Nayette? Ever?
No.
This is the person, turn around, that you said you could have any time, right?
Never.
Okay. Brandon said no. Lie detector determined, however.
I was telling
the truth. That was the
truth. Okay. Thank you.
All right, last question. We asked Brandon, have you ever had sexual relations with another man since you've been dating Darius? Brandon's answer was
yes.
Brandon's answer was yes.
Are you serious?
He's been dating outside of you. That was a confession.
Are you serious? Are you serious? Are you serious?
That was a confession of guilt.
I'm good.
Well, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, honey. I cheated on your ass anyway.
Sit down.
I can sing your chair.
No, there.
Oh, this is an extra chair? Where this came from?
So you cheated on him anyway.
You showing a dick. Like, why wouldn't I?
And you insecurity, that's why, duh.
No, because I look good. I can have whoever I want. Yeah. I can have whatever I want.
So why you?
I had a funny feeling that he was cheating anyway, so I went and did me to complain that game.
Was it good for you?
It was better than that.
Better than me?
Nah. So this relationship is over, right?
I hope so.
Duh.
What
if Ben was over?
See you later, little baby.
Never let later, baby.
You ain't got nowhere to go.
Lies.
All right, here's the reality, right? This is over. Blood is thicker than water. You're going to go and find somebody else. You're going to continue. You're going to live together. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Thanks for the little so-called 3 months relationship. I'm out.
I'm going back to my regular life. I don't have to worry about being accused or going through this drama anymore. He's leaving. Perfect. There's nothing else to argue about.
But you know,
you're going about your life, and we're going to go about ours.
Yeah.
When we return, is this a picture of your ex?
That's him.
So when was the last time you saw him?
A while ago.
Come on out! Stay in a relationship with somebody who isn't over their ex. How many of you think it's acceptable to jump into a relationship when you aren't over an ex? What do you think?
Definitely not. I mean, that they're an ex for a reason. And then, like, you have an emotional, a sexual, like, connection with them. I'm not getting cheated on, so you need to ditch them, kick them to the curb, and, like, be done with that.
Wow, that's strong opinion. Well, my next guest feels he's torn between his ex and his current boyfriend. He says he didn't get closure from in his previous relationship. And before he continues with his current relationship, he wants to be honest with his boyfriend. Let's hear what he has to say. So please welcome Devontae to the show. Devontae, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Mm-hmm.
So, tell me why you feel torn between two men.
Well, my ex and my current, I fell in love with my ex almost 2 years ago, and he just disappeared. We had, like, a few problems. He cheated over and over and over again. I loved him, though, so...
Okay.
I kind of begged him to come back, and then he left completely and not answered any phone calls. So, I then, I took time to get over him, and then I had fallen deeply in love with my current boyfriend. And now it's getting to a point where he's come back into my life, my ex. And
you still have feelings.
Man, yeah. And it's not something that, it's something I was left lingering.
So tell me about your current relationship.
He's amazing. He's everything that my ex wasn't. He's super honest, and if he feels any type of way about anything, he'll let me know, as opposed to just going out and doing whatever you want. There's a valid communication that I didn't have with my ex, but it's cool, though.
So his name is Marcus, and you've been together how long?
8 or 9 months.
But you're communicating now with the ex that disappeared all those years ago?
Yeah, because he contacted me while I was in class one day, and I felt like it probably was an emergency, and hearing his voice kind of, I don't know how to respond anything other than I love you. Like, there's no other response.
Did you tell your ex that you're currently in a relationship? That will be a simple yes or no, but it looks like a no. I didn't tell him you were in a relationship for 8 months with Marcus.
He didn't really ask.
So you didn't tell him?
No.
Does Marcus know that you're talking to your ex?
Okay. So...
Oh.
he...
So I'll take that as a no. So far, you've not been very upfront with these, both of them.
It's not being upfront. It's like,
just kind of bending the truth a little.
Trying to figure out.
So are you playing both men to see who's better? Are you Marcus?
Yes.
Nice to meet you, Marcus.
It's me.
Thanks for coming to the show. So you've been in a relationship for 8 months, right?
Yes.
Duante, and you didn't know?
Not till I just heard what was said.
How does that make you feel?
Upset. Like, why you bring me all the way out here to tell me this? Because you told me back at home.
Why didn't you talk to him?
All right. I love you so much, right?
Me too.
So I told you about the ex that cheated on me all the many times that I was in love with.
Yes.
He contacted me recently, and you remember when you told me to delete the number?
Yes.
I did, but his name is Taylor now.
Taylor? Taylor.
You know the messages that I get at like 2-3 in the morning?
Oh. Oh. Come on, what?
It's a hard situation to deal with because I'm at a point where I'm not sure where or how it was going with him. And
come on, are you laughing? Why are you laughing?
I'm not laughing. It's because I just don't understand. Yo, where are you going?
Why are you laughing? What's funny? Like,
thing is funny. I'm just saying, like, this.
But why didn't you tell him? Why didn't you tell him outright? You were talking to your ex. End of story. But you didn't tell your ex that you were in a relationship with Marcus. Why not?
I told him that somebody was at home. I had somebody at home.
But that's not true. You're in a relationship with a guy, Marcus, for 8 months. It's not
you
somebody
still
at home.
Feelings for him? You still love this guy? Or
you just said he had somebody at home?
I'm going to meet somebody home. Both of you guys.
What?
Whoa.
Nah.
You look amazing.
Why? I don't understand your ex-boyfriend. What was his name?
Antoine.
Antoine. So did you change his name to Taylor?
Yeah, I did in my phone.
Why? To cover up.
No, it wasn't to cover up. No, because...
Why?
No.
So why would you change his name from Anton to Taylor?
Because he contacted me and told me.
Why? Who
the f***? He contacted me and he told me. He was like, yo, how you been? I'm like, oh, I'm good. And we conversed further, and he explained to me, like, I'm changing my name. And I said, okay, that's cool. And then you said, stop texting Antoine. But I wasn't texting Antoine. I was texting.
It's the same person. It's the same person. Like, it's not the same person.
Have you ever suspected that Tavonte is, like, cheating on you?
No.
So you don't mind him talking to his ex under an assumed name in a phone at 3 o'clock in the morning?
See, that's a problem, but I don't feel as though that he going out on dates or doing all that other stuff, but I just don't want him talking to his exes.
You think he was a perfect guy?
But what was missing from him is he has this thing where he kind of doesn't understand sometimes. So if I say I'm talking to my ex, he'll be like, yo, you talking to your ex. What are you talking to them for? And I'm just like, that's my friend. And then he's just like, oh, give me your phone. Now my phone's cleared out and all deleted and I can't.
So let me ask you this. Your ex and you're texting back and forth. Is that texting back and forth like you're trying to get back together?
I was kind of leading him on.
Why?
Because it wasn't technically leading him on. It was like,
yo, you think it's funny though? Why you keep?
It was like he asked questions and I answered them in efficient ways.
Yeah, in efficient ways. That you didn't tell him you had a boyfriend of 8 months.
He didn't technically ask that, but I did tell him.
So you want this relationship to work?
So what were the loose ends between you and Antoine or Taylor or whatever his name is now?
Okay, so Antoine and me, we dated. He cheated on me multiple times. I begged him to come back. He just left. I need closure. I need to explain to him, like, listen, the last thing I got from you was we were in love.
Is this a picture of your ex?
Yeah, that's right.
That's him.
So when was the last time you saw him?
A while ago.
A year ago?
Yeah.
Well, come on out.
You said Antoine.
This was Antoine, but AKA yeah. Taylor.
Taylor.
Welcome, Taylor.
Hi.
So.
Hello. Why you look so crazy? Why you look so crazy? You're shocked.
So you was leading this person on?
I was leading Antoine Taylor on.
No, you're not Antoine. Please respect me.
When I last time I seen you. Last time I seen you. You was a boy. Now you're a whole woman.
Exactly. Like, things change, people change, and I just wasn't myself as that boy that you were in love with.
After the break.
You were in love, and you just finished telling me that you still had feelings, right? And then... Devontae, I've never seen you speechless in the 10 minutes you've been on this stage. Stay tuned. Do you blame someone in your life? So you were communicating back and forth on text.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't know, obviously, that you're now
transitioning.
You were in love, and you just finished telling me that you still had feelings, right? And then...
I have feelings for Antoine. Antoine is a boy.
Taylor.
This is a woman. Taylor is a girl. I like
men. But what does that matter? You're in a relationship.
This is a full woman.
My whole thing is that it was hard for me to just express myself as transgender because growing up, I didn't feel like I had the support from my family.
Okay.
And so I always portrayed this masculine...
But I was supportive on everything that you did.
You were supportive to the masculine me. That's what you were supportive to.
Is this the way you left Devontae, right?
I left Devontae as a male.
Okay.
And I left Devontae because I wasn't happy with being that male. And all my life of being that male...
See, I was the girl.
Yes, and that was the thing. And that was the whole, and that was my whole thing of with Devontae of not being able to tell him that I was transitioning is because in our relationship, he was the feminine one, I was the masculine one. So coming out one day and just saying, oh, I want to transition, that's like hitting someone in their face. So I didn't understand myself as to how to bring that on to someone. Like, even for my family, I've been struggling with this for 24 years with my own family, let alone somebody I've been with for only 2 years. So,
is that one of the reasons you left?
Yes, that was my main reason for leaving, because I was at the point in my life where I had this conversation with my family, and they were like, well, you know what? If you want to do this, Taylor, we completely support you. We're going to be here with you 100%. Like, you're our family. Like, we're not going to leave. So I felt like
me
that...
five times. You're the...
Oh, you cheated on me as Antoine. No, I cheated on you as Antoine, yes. But I feel like with all those doings, like, it was me struggling to find myself.
How you cheat on somebody five times and then wait until after you disappear and say, oh, I needed time to figure out who I wanted
to be.
Maybe
you should have made yourself available to torture.
But you texting this person right here, so why, for what?
I didn't even know you had a boyfriend.
Right? I told you somebody was at my house waiting for me.
Well, you never said it was your boyfriend, though. You said
never
you had
asked.
A friend. You said you had a friend's name.
You said that your name was Taylor. You didn't say you were a whole girl.
Well, why are you see the communication? This person, like, commit on your behalf sucks.
Listen, I am communicating with y'all.
You bring me all the way here to do that.
It's kind of interesting, this. You do an awful lot of talking, but no communicating.
That's how I...
So you didn't know he had a boyfriend. You didn't know she was a girl. You didn't tell him you're transitioning.
No.
Yes. So there's a whole lot of jibber, 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 but no real communication.
There is no real communication.
Well, my thing was...
But you said you had feelings just before Taylor came out here, right? You said you had feelings.
I don't know. I thought that Taylor was just a name change. I didn't know that Taylor was a whole person change. Well, I thought
that
was a
person. What does that matter?
Yeah, I don't...
Exactly. You want to know why it doesn't... It matters because I like men. This is a girl.
But why does it matter? You're with me.
I love you.
All right.
And I love you too. Right.
But the thing is...
My whole thing is, it's not like I'm looking for a relationship from anybody.
Right.
I'm happy on my own. I have my own money. I'm good on my own. Being in a relationship is too much. You see how this is going right now? I don't need this personally. I just came here to clear the air on my name and how I felt and just to give clarity on where I was at in the relationship.
Weren't you texting trying to get back together?
I wouldn't call it getting back together. Like, yes, rekindling. I was not looking for a relationship. Maybe just a friendship, just okay. To reach out and just let you know, like, listen, I apologize for what I did to you and how I treated you and how I lied, but I would hope that we can work things out and be friends. Like, I'm not looking for a relationship. I don't want nobody.
Okay. Taylor's being very blunt. She doesn't want a relationship other than friendship. To say, hey, listen, I'm sorry that I did this, but this is why I did this. Whether you accept it or not, it's up to you. Can you have a friendship with Taylor or no?
No, I can't do it. I don't want to be friends. I don't want to be friends, man.
Okay. Okay. Why?
I don't really need a reason up to why you don't want to be friends with me. There's billions of people in the world. I'll get
absolutely.
Over it.
Well, how does this leave you two now? Because,
man, I want to be in a relationship with him. I love him. This is the first serious male relationship I've been in. So I don't want to lose him over something like petty like this. But if it continues, yeah, I don't... Like,
well, it's not going to continue because he doesn't want that, yeah. And neither of them.
I'm talking about in general.
All right, so you two are going to be happy. You're going to live your life the way you want to live your life. Good luck to all of you. Thanks for coming on and sharing your story. You. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
When Taylor walked out, I felt like, is that? Yeah. I'm definitely still trying to figure out when the hell was I gonna know that my ex-boyfriend was not a boyfriend anymore.
I'm not gonna let nothing petty mess up a good relationship. You know what I mean? So, I don't think it's a big deal.
Still to come, when I saw April and she was the epitome of what you could have become, and to see your face when... Remember when she said...
It hurted me. I mean, because I know it could have been me.
Don't go. One of the best parts of my job is catching up with former guests to see how the show has impacted their lives and finding out if they took my advice. Earlier this season, we met Drashundra and her sister Aisha. Drashundra was concerned because Aisha was getting illegal butt injections to enhance her stripper career. Take a look at this clip.
I've been stripping for about 5 years, since I was like 18, 19. I love the party life. I mean, that's me. That's what I do. I work. I do whatever I do. I take care of myself. I pay my bills. You don't. She don't. They don't.
You are like going to somebody that is not a doctor, not certified, and you're allowing them to put things in your body. How many butt injections today have you had?
I've had two.
We've got cork, mineral oils, wax, silicon, tire sealant, baby oil. These are the things that are put by backstreet surgeons into people like you. You, like Aisha, dabbled in illegal plastic surgery, right?
I got in 2004. By 2011, I was rushed to the hospital with 24 hours to live. I lost both of my feet, both of my hands, and my butt cheeks.
And it's like warning before destruction, you know? It's like warning me. So, I mean, I just didn't stop. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
I believe in you.
Wow. Did Aisha continue getting plastic surgery, or did she change her ways? Please welcome Aisha to the show. Welcome back. So, I remember this so well. April was an amazing guest. What happened after the show?
Well, first, I would like to say you saved my life. I want to thank you because you made me look at everything I told you different. I'm not doing the injections anymore.
You didn't want to listen to me, right?
No, I didn't want to listen. I mean, I watched the show again with everybody. I mean, I saw myself the way that it impacted me and my family. I was crying, like it hurted me. Like, I don't want to do it anymore.
Now, yeah, that's awesome.
Thank you.
And it was for me, I take it very personally. When I saw April and she was the epitome of what you could have become, and to see your face when... Remember what she said?
It hurted me. I mean, because I know it could have been me. And I'm just blessed that it wasn't me. But, I mean, she helped people like me to open my eyes and see if I keep on doing it, that's what's going to happen to me, like, eventually.
So, do you keep in touch with April?
Yes. Actually, me and April text. She keep me motivated. She let me, you know, she helped me open my eyes to see if that's not something that I want.
What do you want people to know about illegal butt injections?
I mean, like, people like me probably, you know, insecure about your body, but I mean, just be happy with what God gave you, because I mean, you only get one body. You only get one body, so you mess it up, what else you gonna do?
So what's next for Aisha?
Well, I'm not doing the implants anymore. I'm thinking about, you know, enrolling in college, do something else with my life. And I don't know what
tell you, you saw when I came out, I just think you're an amazing human being. I love you that you actually came. I really mean that.
Me too.
There's something, guys, that I love about this show, and it really touches people. There are some craziness, there really is, but there are some people that, you know, that go on to do great things, and I think you're going to be one of those,
right,
those people.
Thank you.
So thank you for coming back. Thank Stay you. With us. We'll be right back. Do you have an in-law who's ruining your relationship? I'd like to help. Come be a guest on my show by contacting me at the... I want to thank all my guests for being here today and sharing their stories with us. I want to leave you all with this. One thing, communication works for those who work at it. So in a relationship, when communication starts to fade, everything else will follow. Thanks for watching, and I want to hear from you. So go to our website, therobertirvineshow.com, or visit us on our social media pages. Until next time, be well.